Hey, there he is. Heard you were coming. What's your name, my brother?
Cecil Gaines.
Cecil Gaines.
That ain't funny.
Forrest Whitaker plays the title role in Lee Daniels' film, The Butler. It's inspired by a 2008 Washington Post article and eventual book about Eugene Allen, a White House butler who served 8 presidents.
You said that this was the most intimidating role of your career. Why so?
So many elements to learn. His profession, his vocation. He doesn't get to, he doesn't express certain feelings and emotions out on his sleeve. He can't speak about a lot of different things. So that would mean I would have to communicate to you, as an audience, my thoughts without any words.
The Academy Award-winning actor also ages nearly 70 years throughout the film, where he plays opposite Oprah Winfrey.
What was the name of that movie, honey?
In the Heat of the Night.
In the Heat of the Night with Sidney Poitier?
In her long-awaited return to the big screen, Oprah plays Gloria Gaines, a wife and mother, struggling to keep her family from falling apart under the pressures of racism.
Yo, do no, it! No. Get on out!
Now everybody just sit
I'm
down.
Sorry, Mr. Butler. I didn't mean to make fun of your hero.
Everything you are and everything you have is because of that butler.
I came to the film expecting to see Oprah Winfrey. Instead, I saw my mother, I saw my grandmother, and I saw a few aunts.
Oh, God, that makes me want to... Don't cry. Okay, no, that's the greatest compliment you could pay me. That is just the greatest compliment. That is better than any review you just did for me. And the reason what you've just said made me tear up here is because I was looking for my mother and my aunts and my grandmother and that entire generation of women who stood by their men. They worked hard every day. That's what I was reaching for. And also, understanding that every one of them had their own dreams, their own aspirations, their own desires. They didn't just want to stand by and raise children every day. There were times when they wanted to do more than so. And so they had to repress all that fire.
Oprah credits director Lee Daniels and acting coach Susan Batson for making Gloria come alive in her. And Daniels credits God. The Oscar-nominated director says he actually prays for the fictional characters in his film. His prayer?
That God would take us to the right place to deliver the right message to the right people.
And at its heart, The Butler is a story about the love between a husband and wife.
Something special is going on down here, Dad.
What's so special about another colored man, Jay?
And a father and son at odds about how to fight injustice. David Oyelowo plays the son.
You've described this story as almost prodigal son-like. How so?
What's beautiful about the story is that these two men, one older, one younger, they are both fighting the same thing in very different ways. Mm-hmm. And by the end of the movie, they are able to both celebrate a victory, an unforeseen victory, a victory that they couldn't have imagined would take place.
Oyelowo is part of an all-star cast that includes Jane Fonda, Cuba Gooding Jr., Lenny Kravitz, and Hollywood bad boy, Terrence Howard.
Could your character, Howard, have been a butler in the White House?
No, he didn't have the strength of character to hide one's emotions. To churn one's emotions into where it becomes an action of spirit, and therefore human beings are able to recognize the truth of it and not the emotion of it, not the feeling, but the necessity of it. That's what it would take to be a butler, to be Jesus and wash someone's feet when you are greater than it.
This film takes a rare look at history through the eyes of a humble servant.
Great job. The fruit of the spirit comes alive in the whole film. Thank you.
Does it not? Does it? I'm telling you, when I first saw this film, you know, you're putting it together, it's one thing. And then the first time I saw it, it took my breath away. Just the opening track from Forrest.
Ephraim Graham, CBN News, New York.